Lovely to see both of you. And Debbie, thank you for taking part in this. I can't believe you were existing on like 2 hours sleep.
Yeah, I know.
Wow, you can't.
No, you can't.
You can't. Well, you can up to a point, and then I think something has to give, doesn't it?
Yeah, you think you can.
Yes. So how are you now? Are you still taking the sleeping pills? Or
no.
Good.
I mean, it's only about 10 days since we got together, but I've really sort of slowly introduced everything that the doctors had advised me.
Okay.
And I think you can probably see it in my face, because on that VT, you could see how tired I was.
You did look a wee bit tired.
Yeah. It was from having sort of worked for 7 months physically and mentally exhausted. And it wasn't just the fact that I wasn't sleeping. I couldn't get off to sleep. And then if I did, I slept for 2 hours and woke up at 3 or 4 in the morning.
Yeah. And then can't get back to sleep again because your brain's going.
And then I was getting anxious, and I'm really not an anxious person. And all my grief was sort of coming to the fore. And I thought, this just isn't me. Yeah. So things have been good, haven't they?
Yeah, well, Debbie, just we were chatting beforehand, it's amazing just in 10 days how quickly, you know, you're off the sleeping pills now.
Completely.
Fantastic.
You're getting to bed earlier.
Yeah.
Well, you're falling asleep quicker. And Lorraine, this is not uncommon, you know. People think that I've not slept for years, it's going to take me ages to get it back.
Right.
But it's 4 or 5 often quite simple lifestyle changes.
So you can change that pattern pretty
very quickly.
Yeah. So what did you advise? What were the main things that Debbie changed?
It was to go to bed at least an hour earlier than you want to go to sleep.
Okay.
Cut out all the electronics, no TV. I was always on my iPad in bed.
Me too.
All of that.
Bad, yeah.
Go back to what your grandmother said, having a hot milk before bed. That's really helped.
Okay.
Spraying my pillow with lavender oil or a lavender spray.
Oh.
And I can feel it when you breathe it in. You can feel that it makes you calm.
Yeah, you feel more relaxed. You can feel all that stress oozing away.
Cutting down the caffeine.
Right. That was a big one, wasn't it?
And the chocolate, which you don't think of, do you? But it's not just tea and coffee.
Chocolate's got caffeine in. So a lot of people don't realise if you're having particularly...
You should have a biscuit and a cup of tea at night before you go to bed, don't you?
It is amazing that. And you were waking up, I think, quite early, weren't you?
Yeah.
4:30 in the morning. And what a lot of people don't realise with caffeine, and it's going to make me very unpopular, I understand this, but caffeine takes a long time to get out of your system. So even if you have a cup of coffee at midday, about a quarter to half of that is still in your body at midnight.
Uh-huh.
Right, but most of us wouldn't have a quarter of a cup of coffee just before we go to bed.
No, of course not. No.
And I used to wake up at 4:30 when I was drinking way too much coffee. And it was almost that was when it was going out of my body. And my body was withdrawing and I needed to wake up. So it's, although people don't want to think about it, I'd say tea and coffee in the morning.
Right, and try not to.
Yeah, but ideally, if you're really struggling with your sleep, you know, cut it out for a week and see how you do.
Absolutely. Do you feel better in yourself? Do you feel you've got more energy? Because you're the most energetic woman I know, I think.
I just feel back to normal.
Right.
And also, because what people don't realise is when you get really overtired, you start to get anxious.
Yeah.
And then you get anxious, you go to bed thinking, I'm never going to get to sleep. And then you're worrying about everything in your life. And that has just slowly gone away. I get a little bit of kind of butterfly nerves halfway through the day if I'm working and I'm tired. But mostly, I can see that everything is just slotting back into place of how I was before. My energy definitely is back with coming off the sleeping pills and doing all those things and trying most nights to get to bed at the same time. I just feel a different person.
I'm really, really glad because you've been working so hard. You've had a rotten time. I mean, it's 2 years almost to the day in a week. And that's really tough as well.
Yeah.
That was
climbing on top of me.
Exactly.
But now I'm dealing with it.
Oh, that's good. They were saying, in some of the papers were saying today, that you feel almost ready, not yet, but almost ready to maybe start thinking about perhaps sharing your life with someone else. Maybe.
Well, I said, you know, where a year ago I couldn't even contemplate thinking about it, it's not in my head now.
That's good. That's good progress, Debbie. Yeah. It really is. And he would have wanted you to be happy. He just would have wanted you to be happy. If it happens, it happens. It doesn't, it doesn't.
Yeah.
Your life is full.
Yes,
you've got
absolutely
an amazing, full life. Yeah. You never stop.
No.
You just never stop. We're going to catch up with you in a couple of weeks, though, because obviously it's early days.
Yes.
And just to make sure that things are going well and it's all working out. But so far, so good, huh?
Superb. Just in 10 days, that's amazing. And,
really,
and the thing I think which has really worked for Debbie, which I think is really important for people watching this, Lorraine, is we've all got a threshold of sleep, right? So we can deal with multiple insults up to a point. So too much caffeine, too much stress, too much work, too much alcohol. but then we tip over. And we were talking beforehand, Debbie, that obviously losing Paul a couple of years ago is a huge stress on the body. And actually, what that's done is that it's raised you from here. You're very near your threshold now because of that. So that's why maybe you could get away with other things like caffeine, maybe alcohol, maybe working too much in the past. But you've got to really optimise them now because you're much nearer that threshold.
Exactly.
And that's why I think doing three or four small things has that big impact.
No,
and
that makes perfect sense.
I think we quickly said that this has been a short period of time since I've been trying these things. Mm. You know, 10 days ago when we met, I've got a really busy week this week and I'm promoting, I've got a pilgrimage programme coming out on BBC Two on Friday. And every day I've got things going on. When we met, I was thinking, I'm never going to get through that week.
Right, and you were worried about it.
And now I can't wait for this week to do all those things.
I'm so happy to hear that. That's phenomenal.
I'm looking forward to that, because I know that area very, very well.
Yeah.
Debbie, thank you. We'll catch up with you in a couple of weeks.
Thank you.
Thank you so, so much, Dr. Chatty. Thank you.